The lowering sun causes the golden kingdom of Asgard to shine bright. Buildings tower up and mix with the stars, each more magnificent and elegant than the previous. The rainbow bridge connecting Asgard to the rest of the realms stretches to its farthest reaches, safely protected by its ever-vigilant guardian, I, Heimdall. Within the glorious gilded palace at the center of Asgard herself currently sits King Odin, son of Bor, on his decadent throne. Sitting close by to him are his two young children, the blonde and strong Thor, and the dark-haired and clever Loki. Their mother, Frigga, stands back behind them and listens.
Father, please tell us a story!
Yes, father, it's far too early to rest.
Gather close, my sons, and I shall tell you a tale of fierce bravery, a story of your grandfather, Bor, and his tangle with the Dark Elves.
Oh, Odin, not anything too violent.
These boys will grow up to be warriors one day, Frigga. They need tales that will inspire them.
Well, all right, you do have a point.
Careful, father. You might scare dear little Thor over here.
I'm not scared! Aren't the Dark Elves gone anyhow?
Gone, but not gone for good, I fear. The possibility of their return is ever looming over us like the clouds in Midgard. One day, Asgard will gain two strong guardians to protect it from such threats.
Thor and Loki turn to each other with large grins on their faces and then back to their father, excitedly awaiting his tale.
Centuries ago, my father was alerted of an attack on the Bifrost. The Dark Elves had an ancient mystical artifact that allowed them to teleport into Asgard, and only Asgard. He swiftly assembled his army and launched to attack. Thor, brawny and fierce, led the strike with the powerful weapon Mjolnir in hand.
Grandfather wielded Mjolnir?
Yes, he was worthy of Nidavellir's strongest weapon. Perhaps one day too, you shall be worthy of it as well, Thor.
What about me, father?
It is only meant for the heir to the throne, my son.
And if Thor were to die, would that not be me?
That'd never happen, you knave!
Thor and Loki jump at each other and get ready to fight. But Odin slams down his staff and stops them instantly.
Do you not want to hear the rest of the story? We've only just begun.
Loki shoots Thor a glare, and the two of them settle back down.
As I was saying, King Bor readied himself for the battle ahead, securing a gilded horned helm atop his head in the Asgardian throne room. He threw out his mettled left hand. Mere seconds later, Mjolnir flies into his hand, and he grasps it with all his strength, ready to use it to slay Asgard's attackers. Soldiers in similar armor rush to his side in the throne room, each carrying a sword, spears, hammers, or maces.
King Bor, we are prepared to serve at your side, and willing to die to defend Asgard's people.
Very well, my men. You are the finest Asgard has, and I know you will do well by me. Has anyone seen these attackers firsthand?
A small but quick-footed soldier steps in front of King Bor's fighting force.
Aye, my king! I have laid eyes upon them. I fear they are a unit of Dark Elves, and they are making for the palace.
A tough battle, forsooth. Let us not keep them waiting, then. For Asgard!
For Asgard!
The fearless men and women of Asgard rush alongside their king into battle. They burst out of the palace and headed straight for the ever-important Bifrost. Once there, they find a menacing horde of Dark Elves anxious to tear down our great realm. Without a second of consideration, the brave warriors attack the raging swarm.
How many were there, father? How many Dark Elves?
Hundreds, my boy! They were unrelenting in their attacks. Swords clattered, spears stabbed, blood spilled all over the Bifrost. Many of our soldiers fell that day, yet there were even more casualties on theirs. The battle stretched on and our people gave it their all, but their strength began to wane.
My king! A group of elves broke off from the rest, and they're headed for the palace!
Leave them to me.
With a great bound, King Thor charged away from his army and leaped straight towards the palace to cut them at the pass. He lands in the middle of their group, smashing two of their warriors. The rest quickly surround him. The Dark Elves rush towards your grandfather with their deadly spears, but Bor knows what he's doing. Two vile elves step their spears simultaneous, but Thor strafes out of the way and throws Mjolnir at them. The mighty hammer crashes into the chest of one of the elves and hits the other in the head. Both elves spin away from the battlefield. Another foot soldier attempts to slam his mace into Thor's head, but is launched away when Mjolnir hits him before returning to the hand of its master. Thor and Mjolnir fly one last time. Tired of dealing with the Dark Elves and controlling it to arc around in a circle, driving it to the rest of the surrounding Dark Elves, and they all toppled down. Mjolnir returned to the hand of its master. The army of the Dark Elves began feeling the blow of Asgard's might and knew they could not win their battle. They quickly retreated back to their home of Svartalfheim.
Then what happened?
King Thor knew there was only one way to deal with the Dark Elves. As long as they still held some power, they would not stop trying to usurp more. He led a grand army to their realm and defeated their fighting force and leader, Malekith the Accursed. After their great loss, the Dark Elves disappeared suddenly in a cloud of smoke. Sadly, though, Malekith managed to hex him before fading away, and he could no longer wield Mjolnir again. Thor spent a good part of his life trying to track them down, but he never could find where they went. Rumors float around still to this day, but it is still unknown what happened to them. No Dark Elf has been seen since the time of Thor.
If they do return, I'll put an end to them once and for all!
Please, you can't even wield Mjolnir yet. What are you going to do? Use that wimpy dagger you call a sword and slay them all?
You'll see, Loki. One day, I'll be a great warrior!
Enough! For I know in my heart that one day of you shall become indeed one of Asgard's finest warriors. With enough training, you may even be greater than King Thor himself.
A great big grin shines brightly on young Thor's face while Loki rolls his eyes, doubting his brother's great supposed future. Several decades later, the sun currently shines on the sprawling field just by Asgard's golden palace, green grass as far as the eye can view. A lone tree holding up a heap of leaves with its strong branches stretches out from the flat plains and it currently shades in Elder Loki, eating a crisp green apple. He consumes it loudly while watching one of his favorite forms of entertainment. Though the plains seem pristine and calm, that is far from the truth now. Thor and the other warriors practice their skills in the open air, using dulled wooden weapons for safety purposes. Thor spars with one of his close friends, the dirty blonde and expert swordsman Fandral. Their practice swords slash back and forth at another, neither of them landing a hit yet.
What's your footing?
My footing is fine, Fandral. Ah!
Are you sure about that?
The large and bearded Volstagg turns around from his duel with Hogun to admire Thor's mistake.
Laugh it up, Volstagg. That was a cheap blow.
All's fair in wooden swordplay, my friend.
Fandral stands over Thor and reaches his hand out to help him up. Thor graciously accepts it, and with all of his might, Fandral pulls him up.
My, you're getting heavier. Been feasting on too much mutton like Volstagg again?
I can't help it. That mutton just tastes so good.
A woman adorned in shiny metal armor saunters over to the others. She, too, is watching from a near distance, like Loki. By the look on her face, she looks unimpressed.
There's still room for improvement, Thor, but you're getting better.
Is that so, Sif?
Your technique's off. An enemy could easily counter your left slashes. You need to build up your guard.
Perhaps I could show you a few techniques, Lady Sif.
Lady Sif rolls her eyes at Loki's remark.
Why don't you stop behaving like a wart on a toad and come face me yourself?
Oh? Wish to test my skill, do you?
Something like that.
It would be my pleasure to school you, brother.
You may learn something yourself.
Such as how not to duel an opponent?
Loki steps out from the shade of his tree and moves closer to Thor. He summons two wooden daggers into his hands from thin air.
Enough talk, sparkle fingers. Let Thor best you already.
Fandral and Volstagg turn to Hogun with confused looks on their faces, and Hogun shrugs at them.
Just saying what you were thinking.
Loki gets in a battle stance and smirks at Thor. He returns a similar smirk. They stand for a moment, giving one another an intimidating stare. Lady Sif and the Warriors Three have their eyes locked on the two opponents,
not wanting to miss a second of the battle that is about to occur. Thor begins to gradually step closer to Loki as they now start circling each other. Loki suddenly dashes at Thor, swinging his left wooden dagger as he runs. Thor parries it with his practiced sword and dodges another slash from Loki's right hand. Thor kicks it at Loki's legs, but he's quicker. Loki slides to the right just in time and stabs up at Thor's rib. Thor swings his sword at Loki in rage, and it skims his brother's chest, almost sending Loki toppling over. Just then, the sound of boots running nears the warriors. Thor turns his attention to see who's the source, and Loki's about to strike another blow when curiosity gets the best of him, and he peeks too. A woman in standard guard armor rushes at them urgently.
What's going on?
It's Niflheim, sirs. A group of dark elves has been attacking its cities.
I must have misheard you. Did you say dark elves?
You didn't mishear me, Prince. The dark elves have resurfaced and are trying to take Niflheim.
Well, that can't be good.
No kidding.
Why have the dark elves suddenly chosen now to make themselves known again?
I say we go find out. What say you, brother?
It seems our little duel shall have to wait.
To the Bifrost, then.
Wait. There's something I wish to try.
Do you expect any different result from the last time?
It's worth a try. It would be a great asset to us in Niflheim.
Thor tosses down his wooden practice sword and sprints towards the Golden Palace of Asgard. The warriors three with Loki follow behind him, and Lady Sif begrudgingly follows suit. The pack of warriors walk through the halls of Odin's palace and out to a courtyard in the middle of the structure. There stands a few beautiful trees, a small crystal clear pond, and a hammer sitting on a pedestal. The very hammer Bor used to fight out the Dark Elves so many centuries ago. Mjolnir.
You know you won't be able to wield that yet, right?
Thank you for your faith in me, brother.
Thor walks up to the pedestal and places his hands on the handle of Mjolnir. He lifts with all of his might, hoping for it to budge even a centimeter. He has no luck. The hammer stubbornly stays in its spot.
Oh, I don't understand! What must I do to pick this damn hammer up?
Why do you require it now, though? Your father said that you would be worthy one day, so why rush it?
I require it to destroy the Dark Elves once and for all, to continue my grandfather's work.
The beautiful and wise Frigga walks onto the scene.
My son, Volstagg is right. You need to be patient with Mjolnir. It will call you master when you are ready.
And when will that be? If it is my destiny to wield it, why must I wait? I could do great feats now if it would let me.
Your time will come, Thor, but not yet. You must be true to yourself. And when Mjolnir knows you are, it will come to you, not you to it. It doesn't define you. It harmonizes with you.
Am I not true to myself now? I know who I am inside. A warrior, willing to do anything, take any risk to destroy my enemies.
Oh, Thor, you are much more than that. Now we're wasting time here. Niflheim needs you, all of you. Go swiftly and be careful.
Thor nods and begins to walk back inside the palace, heading towards the Bifrost. Frigga watches them as they depart, worrying for each of their safety, but having faith in their abilities. The company sprints through the halls of Asgard's palace, and as they pass by its many hallways, armed troops join in. One of the troops tosses Thor's sword, landing perfectly in his hands.
Let's go kill these bastards.
I watch the strong fighting force draw closer to my post, and I prepare to do my duty. At last, they reach the portal to the realms.
Heimdall, what have you seen of the attack on Niflheim?
The Dark Elves have been ravaging the main city. The Frost Giants have been attempting to push them back to the outer reaches of the city, but it hasn't worked yet. If you do not act soon, the capital will fall and the thousands of Dark Elves there will be the launching point for more attacks. Do not let them take Niflheim, Odinson.
Wasn't planning on it.
I stab my sword down to the Bifrost's lock, and it begins to work its magic. A portal opens directly in front of me and the warriors, letting in the harsh and frosted air of Niflheim, land of the Frost Giants. Thor motions everyone to follow after him as he charges into the Bifrost's opening.
Here we go.
Thor Odinson's army plunges into the cold, ready for the long battle in front of them. I close the portal behind them when their last fighter rushes in. I watch the battle from my post with all the focus I can muster, believing in their chances of victory. Thor gathers his fighters and assesses the situation.
Where have all these Dark Elves been hiding anyhow? Heimdall mentioned their numbers reaching the thousands.
We needn't worry about that right now. We need a plan.
If any of them survive this, we'll ask them for a history lesson.
More like if any of us survive this. Surely we are outnumbered.
It isn't always about how many warriors you have, Hogun, but how you use them. I say Fandral, Volstagg, Lady Sif and I attack the Horde straight on, while Loki and Hogun lead two separate teams to attack their sides and surround them. Once we've mowed down enough, they won't be able to escape our human barrier.
It sounds a little risky, but I suppose it's our only option. With the help of the Frost Giants, perhaps today will end in victory.
Victory will be ours, brother. Let's get this over with. And remember, do not let any of the elves escape back from whence they came. Their time is over.
For Asgard!
Loki and Hogun lead two teams of soldiers to flank the Dark Elf attackers, while Thor, Lady Sif, Volstagg, and Fandral hasten to battle in the Glacial City. They dash through the inner wall of Niflheim's capital city and past the ruins of smoking buildings and dancing fires, spreading more destruction and ash. The sound of war is joining on closer from the Frost Giants desperately trying to keep the Dark Elves in their own palace. Swords clash and spears pierce, bodies pile on the streets. Thor and his band of soldiers reach the battle at last. Thor is the first one into the fight, slashing his sword at a nearby Dark Elf who catches the blade on his face. The Dark Elf kicks the current Frost Giant who is fighting away and focuses the attention of Thor. His black steel sword flashes in front of Thor, not touching him however, as he quickly dodges out of his path. Another swing comes from the Dark Elf, but this time Thor parries it. He breaks off from his enemy's sword and plunges his into the chest of the Dark Elf. The blue light in the elf's eyes fades and his body collapses. Thor begins to feel the rush of the battle around him, allowing it to invigorate him and enrage him. A Dark Elf launches a surprise attack at the prince, almost getting her spear into his back, but the spear slaps the crushing hit of Lady Sif's sword. Before the attacker can react, Lady Sif drives her sword clean into the throat of the spear holder. Her eyes roll to the back of her head as she plumps the hard thud to the ground. Thor wheels around to admire Lady Sif's handiwork.
Thanks for that.
Lady Sif nods in response for plunging back into battle with her fellow comrades. Fandral defeats one Dark Elf and moves on to the next without a second thought. A larger and heavily armored enemy smashes through a pair of Frost Giants and sprints toward their icicle palace, but Volstagg blocks his path. The muscular elf slashes his twin swords at Volstagg, but he catches them with his axe. The bearded warrior flings one sword out of his elf's hands, but he grips the other firmly. The sword slides out of Volstagg's axe and swishes to his face, but he moves just in time. Volstagg slams his opponent hard into the chest of his opponent, but the hard chest plate he wears takes most of the blow. Volstagg rips the axe from his enemy's armor plate and slices the elf's neck, sending his head flying.
Could a fat pig do that?
Lady Sif currently fights two Dark Elves, one attempting to hit her with an axe while the other runs with a spear. She acts fast, sliding out of the axe swing and zooming to the elf with the spear. She runs her sword down the wooden weapon and she propels forward, snapping it. The elf throws the broken spear away out of anger and draws a dagger. Before he can send another attack, Lady Sif throws the sword into the face, jabbing hard into it, the elf falls over. She turns her attention to the other elf, who tries swinging at her again. She narrowly moves to the left and delivers a punch to his arm, but it has little effect. The Dark Elf raises his axe above his head and a blade pierces through his chest. Thor's sword. He draws it out quick and kicks the dead soldier out of the way.
Just thought I'd return the favor.
Thanks. We could really use Hogun and Loki's warriors right now.
They'll be here soon. Stay strong.
Always.
Lady Sif retrieves her sword from the dead elf and returns to fight another. Away from the battle, however, dark plots are being put into effect. On the supposedly abandoned Dark Elf home realm of Svartalfheim, the scarred Malekith and his right hand, Kurse, watch their attacking force from afar with the help of magic. They sit in a makeshift throne room at a dugout headquarters under the surface of the realm. As they watch the outcome, a crooked smile stretches on Malekith's face when he sees his elves forcing back the ferocious Frost Giants.
My master, are you certain this plan will work? The Asgardians are bound to arrive soon, and with their powerful fighting force, they could surely defeat our army expeditiously. I mean no disrespect, but this part of your plan seems to not work as well as you expected.
You were wrong, Kurse. Their strongest people may be in Niflheim fighting our force. But must I remind you that our group leading the attack there is not even half the army we possess?
Once they defeat the elves in Niflheim, they will return home and will be even stronger with all of their troops stationed in Asgard, making it likely that they will defeat the remainder of our people.
That is why we must attack Asgard as soon as possible. Once we get sight of their Thor, Odinson, and Niflheim, we will transport our warriors into the heart of Asgard. We must fight with all of our strength and take control of the destroyer before Thor returns. Once he is back, then we will kill him with ease.
It will be difficult, but you are right, Malekith. I have faith in our force. Their hunger for revenge is almost as much as yours.
Look, Kurse, there's Asgard's strongest warrior himself in Niflheim, just as we'd hoped. Now the time has come. Launch the attack!
Kurse nods and immediately stands out of his seat, dashing to the barracks where all the Dark Elves await their orders. They all stand at attention when they see Kurse enter the large, carved-out room.
Today, my warriors, your day for revenge has arrived. We will show Asgard the might of the Dark Elves of Svartalheim and rewrite history. No more shall our people be made fools of. The defeated and wiped out civilization of the Nine Realms. Asgard's time is over. We shall reign over all the realms.
The Dark Elf warriors rush forth with their sharp sabers and spears, ready to smear them with Asgardian blood. While the battle ensues, Loki leads his company of soldiers to the frosty landscape of Niflheim, nearing its main city. The warriors behind him are itching to join in the fight, having never experienced war with the Dark Elves.
My prince, when shall we reach the inner city? Our people could be dying right now. We need to hasten our journey.
Relax. I sense that we aren't too far off now. My brother and the warriors can hold off.
Loki cranes around, confused at who is calling him.
Did any of you hear that?
Hear what, sir?
Odin has been keeping your origins a secret, Loki.
Sir?
Find me, if you wish to know.
Shall we continue?
Lead on. I'll catch up.
Loki departs from his group of fighters and they all watch him curiously. After a moment, they decide it is better to continue on and help the rest of the fighting force. Loki walks through the icy land, as if being pulled by a thread. He stumbles upon a grand frozen cave, its dark opening like a black hole. Loki summons a ball of fire in his now raised left hand, creates a sword as a precaution in his right, and begins to walk in. He shivers a little at the cold wind emanating from deep in the cave, adding more power to his light source to warm him up a little. Loki continues walking towards the heart of the cave, looking for any signs of life, shining his light all around.
Hello? Tis I, Loki Odinson. I believe I was called here.
Odinson? A lie.
A lie? But I'm the son of Odin. Where are you? Who are you?
Out from the deep shadows steps the ruler of all Dark Elves, Malekith. Loki points his sword upward at him immediately.
What trap is this, villain?
I am not the villain here, Loki. It is your father that is.
And what has he done?
He has lied to you. You are no son of Odin.
Is that so? Well then, whose son am I?
You are the spawn of Lofi, former king of Niflheim, the very realm you are in now.
Malekith motions his hand over to the left and Loki's eyes follow. A vision of King Laukey is now visible.
How desperate are you to win me over to your side? Why would I believe a single word that you say? If you want to see Asgard in ruin, then I should strike you down right now.
You could try, but the attempt would be futile. And also you assume wrong. I do not wish to see Asgard in ruin. I wish to have a hold over it, to see another rule it by my side.
That doesn't make any sense. I've always been told that your kind only wishes to destroy the realms.
Another lie from your youth. No, Asgard's tight rule on the realm has been too strong for too many years. It's time for new leadership. This is not my concern right now, though. My concern is on you.
What do you want of me?
You are the person I want to rule by. Haven't you ever in your life wanted to be king?
None of this matters! I know you're trying to get into my mind. Twist what I know!
Loki steps closer to Malekith, pointing his sword closer to him.
I am only trying to tell you what you don't know. I have proof of your lineage. I saw when your father stole you after a battle with the Frost Giants.
Malekith crafts another apparition, this time of a younger Odin in Niflheim's frozen palace, picking up an infant Frost Giant and walking out of the scene.
He stole you from your true home after causing the death of your father.
Then why do I not still look like a Frost Giant?
Perhaps you were too young to remember your false mother changing your appearance with her magic.
You're stretching this awfully far. You know that, right?
Asgardian blood is red, yes.
Of course it's red.
Then, have you never once bled?
Not in battle, no. I use magic to protect myself. I'm not a barbarian.
Cut yourself.
Excuse me?
If your blood is red, I will have lied to you. If not, well, surely you're curious.
Fine. I'll play your game.
Loki gingerly slides his sword on his left hand, causing beads of blood to seep out. To his shock, his blood is blue.
This must be some trick. Your magic is clearly powerful.
It is no trick, Lofason. Now you know your true lineage. All of your life, Odin hasn't treated you fairly and has lied to your face several times. Now you know the truth.
What is your plan?
On the other far side of the Frost Giant's main city, Hogun leads his men closer to the battle. Their ears perk up at the coming sounds of battle. Hogan's ears hear another very faint and nearby sound, but he keeps on leading his warriors in order to not alert who's making said noise that he knows.
Ready yourself. The Dark Elves are fierce warriors.
Hogun draws his bow and knocks an arrow out. Without warning, he reels around and fires an arrow, quickly loading another and firing into the right of the other arrow. Both arrows collide with two Dark Elves, who thought they were being quiet enough to surprise attack the company. They were not.
But apparently they're not good at stealth.
Hogun lifts up his bow and runs toward the city, and a flood of warriors sprint behind him. On the other side of the city, nearly at the same time rushes Loki's men too, closing in on the Dark Elves' force. Thor and the rest of his friends fight hard as more elven foes fall, but Asgardians too litter the red, snowy ground. Some of the elves look up from their battle in surprise at the sudden influx of warriors from both sides.
Finally!
Face the full fight of Asgard now, villains!
The Dark Elves' numbers deplete faster than they had before. Asgardian warriors slash through them like blades of grass. Thor finds himself against a higher-ranked elf wielding two swords, scarred from the skirmish, but still having energy to continue on.
You may win here, Odinson, but we shall destroy you soon enough.
Not likely. Once we're done here, we'll search for the rest of you and root you out once and for all.
I highly doubt it. Shame you won't see Asgard's demise, though.
The elite elf swipes snow into Thor's eyes, temporarily blinding him. His foe swings at him as Thor tries to uncover his eyes and clear his vision. Thor steps a little to the side, but is still hit by his enemy's sword. Thor's left arm begins to bleed from the wound, but it's not too severe yet. Thor at last gains his vision and strikes at the elf. The elite fighter blocks the attack with one sword and slices Thor's chest.
Damn you!
The armor takes most of the attack, but it still manages to cut a little into Thor. A small flowing stream of blood begins to slip out from the wound. Thor breaks free from the elf and takes a step back to catch his breath. The elite elf doesn't give Thor much of a breather as he launches to attack once again, not wanting to feel the sting of his enemy's sword yet again. Thor strengthens his stance and parries the blow. He arcs fast, sending another sweep at the elven foe, who then blocks it with his other sword. Thor spins the elf's left sword out of his hand, and it embeds itself in a near snow pile. The foe shifts his other hand to his remaining sword and slams it against Thor's sword again and again, trying to break his defense. Thor holds strong enough though and sees his opportunity. Just a second before the Dark Elf swings his sword once more at Thor, he stabs at his stomach. While the battle rages in Niflheim, all is normal in Asgard. Or so it seems. Guards walk across the Rainbow Bridge, making their normal patrol rounds. The air on the bridge starts to cool up normally though. Blue sparks start forming a large circle.
What the hell?
The guardsmen move closer to the circle and motions for the other guards to join them. They point their spears at it as it now completes, opening up a portal to the Dark Elf homeworld and giving the sentries a look at what's coming. Kurse stands at the front of a large attacking force of Dark Elves, all holding various sharp weapons.
Forward!
The crowd yells in rage and charges to the newly formed portal.
Go! Get reinforcements! And hurry, there's no way we can hold off all these Dark Elves for long.
The guardsman runs as fast as his legs will carry him back to the Palace of Asgard. I myself know what I must do. I close my eyes and focus on Thor Odinson. My spirit flies out of my body and speeds to him, landing beside him as he defeats another attacker.
Odin's beard, Heimdall! What are you doing here?
Asgard is under attack, Odinson. I fear this battle is only a destruction. The numbers invading our home are double this force, if not more.
How could we be so foolish to rush here and leave Asgard defenseless? We'll be there as soon as possible. Hang in there, Heimdall!
Hurry! It won't be long before they reach the palace.
Aye.
I return back to my body, ready myself to give it all for Asgard. I draw my large golden sword and hold back the Dark Elves currently headed for the Bifrost's control. Back in Niflheim, Thor slashes through enemy after enemy, trying to shorten their fight.
Asgard is under attack. We need to get back there sooner rather than later.
I say you, Lady Sif, Loki, Volstagg, and some of our men head back there. Myself and Hogun can finish up here.
That works for me.
Right. Wait, where is Loki?
Thor cranes around in search of his brother, but cannot seem to locate him. On cue, though, Loki enters the battlefield. He appears in the middle of a crowd of Dark Elves and summons a handful of daggers. He throws them every which way, each one stabbing through the elf. Just like that, 12 elves are no more.
Did you miss me?
Where were you?
Oh, just making a little side trip, taking in the sights and whatnot.
Asgard is in trouble. We need to get back now.
Let me guess. More Dark Elves?
They've launched an invasion force. Apparently there are more of these bastards hiding somewhere.
This day just keeps getting more and more fun, doesn't it?
Heimdall, we need a portal.
Give me a moment! 3 Dark Elves attempt to fight their way into my domain, but I refuse to let them win. I stab one of these in the chest, but the other two put up more of a fight. Mine and other swords collide while another tries to get me with her spear, which I dodge out of the way. I break off from the swordsman and cut him on the leg.
Is that it?
No. I use my might to break his sword with mine and slice his throat before he reacts. His body careens off the bridge. The spearwoman stabs at me again and yet misses again. I knock her with the back end of my sword and she falls back to join a fallen comrade. Now that that's over with, I walk back into my post and stab my sword into the Bifrost lock, opening a portal from Niflheim to Asgard. Thor, Loki, Lady Sif, and Volstagg waste no time running through the portal and arriving at my doorstep. More of Asgard's finest stream back to their homeland.
What's the situation?
Dark Elves are slowly making their way to the palace through a portal to their world. Your father is preparing to launch an attack from the palace in an attempt to draw them back to the portal.
Come on, let's join him.
Thor leads the way to the portal, mowing down any villain that stands in his way. The rest of us follow him through the path he's made, as if he's dug a tunnel through a strong mountain. Inside Asgard's palace, Odin and his own elite fighters ready themselves to defend Asgard from their dark invaders. Odin wishes he could wield Mjolnir, knowing it would guarantee victory. In his heart, he feels unworthy, however, and cannot summon it. He puts on battle-worn armor and sharpens the end of his staff. Frigga walks into the armory with a face of concern.
Be careful out there, my king. Asgard can't afford to lose you.
If I fail, that will be the least of our worries. If my time does come, my queen, this is an honorable way for me to pass. When it is my time, I know that Thor will be ready.
He has a lot to learn.
He does, and he will learn his place in the universe. I can see it now. You'll be much wiser than I ever was. All of this right here, it's all my fault, truly.
Odin bows his head in shame for his inactiveness.
Odin, no one could have predicted this. Instead of moping around about it, do something. Don't worry about the past. Change the future.
You're right. I shall end our struggle for good.
Frigga gives Odin a kiss for good luck and uses her magic to strengthen his armor.
This spell will protect you from blades, but it shan't stop powerful magic.
Thank you, Frigga.
Frigga gives Odin a warm smile, and without a second thought, Odin grabs his staff and leads his force out of the palace. His men and women follow closely behind him and charge full force into the dark hall, prepared to give it all up for the safety of their home. Odin swings his staff around, dividing several Dark Elves' bodies. Thor notices his father and brings his band over to him.
There you are, my boy. Was your battle successful, Nilfheim?
As far as I know, the battle still rages on. I've left Fandral and Hogun to restore order. Father, Niflheim was a diversion. Here is where the true prize is.
Clearly!
Thor, Odin, and Loki fight together, side by side, one family united under combat. Thor's sword kills an attacker who nearly got to Loki. He nods his appreciation as he summons a great sword.
This should do the trick. Dark!
Thor and Odin hit the ground, just missing Loki's dangerous blade spinning around them. Dark Elves try to move back from it, but are blocked by their comrades. Torsos separate from legs and add to the carnage on the bright bridge. A Dark Elf jumps up and tries to land a blow to Loki's head, but Thor too jumps out of the way of the scythe and cuts him down. Thor lands and rolls out of the scythe's path. Loki stops spinning when he's satisfied with the dent he put in their fighting force.
It is good seeing you two cooperate for once.
Nothing brings the Odinsons together like war.
Aye, you can say that again.
I fight my way to the king and his princess to give him important news, leaving little time for finesse. More dead are added to the stock.
Heimdall, what is it?
I have had a vision, my king. It is the leader of the Dark Elves, and he is in our great palace.
I shall meet him. You stay here and fight the swarm, father. If that pleases you.
Spoken like a future king.
Thor smiles at that remark and goes hell for leather to the palace. Luckily for him, the master's swords and spears has yet to reach the magnificent structure, as Lady Sif, Volstagg, and the other Asgardians hold it back. He walks in to find Frigga strewn over the throne, eyes closed. Thor fears the worst and wastes no time running to her.
Mother!
Thor shakes her, trying to wake her. Her eyes dart open suddenly.
Mother, what happened?
Was Malekith. He somehow sneaked into the throne room. I tried to stop him. His magic is much stronger than I anticipated, and he got the better of me.
Where is he now?
I think I saw him head for the armory before I fainted.
Then that is where I must go. I'm ending this.
Take heed, my son. He's powerful.
As am I.
Wait, before you go, allow me to heal you.
Mother, you're too weak.
Nonsense. You'll need your full strength to defeat him.
Thor steps closer to his mother, and her hands begin to glow. She presses them against Thor's wounds, causing the blood to recede back in. The cuts completely disappear from his skin, and she smiles up at him before fainting again.
Now go, my son. Finish it.
Thor grips his sword tight as he saunters off to the armory, prepared to block any attack that suddenly launched at him. He's pleasantly surprised to find that no such attack comes. As he draws closer to the armory, he notices the few guards left to guard the Hall of Weaponry are now in the afterlife. Thor's pace slows as he enters at the armory, the den of the beast. He sees the beast himself too, working on the panel that controls a deadly weapon, the Destroyer.
Halt right there, Malekith. Step away from the panel.
If I were to do that, would you not still slaughter me?
I might consider giving you mercy. More mercy than you give my people out there in the thick of battle.
Malekith turns away from the panel to face Thor, allowing a little anger to show in his eyes.
I show the same mercy your people did when they stabbed my people in the back.
How do you mean? You were the ones that invaded Asgard in the first place, villain.
Odin has failed another one of his children, it seems. Or perhaps it was Bor who failed his son. Whoever has lied to you, it seems to run in the family.
What lie? You purposefully attacked Asgard and her people, without cause.
Your grandfather Bor forced us to attack Asgard.
And why would he do that? Better yet, why should I let you waste my time?
Thor charges at Malekith with his sword pointing straight towards him. Malekith barely reacts, simply moving his hand to the right. A simple gesture sends Thor flying into a shelf of shields.
It doesn't matter to me if you believe my words. I know the truth because I was there. Bor captured my family and threatened to kill them if we didn't attack Asgard. Though we did listen to his demands, he didn't keep his word and is the murderer of the ones I love.
That is the worst lie I've ever heard.
The reason being that it is not a lie.
What would my grandfather gain from Dark Elves invading Asgard?
We had valuable resources on our realm. Ones that made your destroyer. We didn't allow him to possess them, so he turned to violence like many of your ancestors of yore.
Thor ignores what he thinks are distractions and continues to attempt to fight Malekith. He lands a small cut on Malekith's arm in a fury of attacks. Malekith's angered by this and fires his magic at Thor, holding him against the wall.
I will give you an ultimatum. Join me and cooperate. I will allow you to keep the throne of Asgard, but your realm will not hold all of the power like it does now. It is time for change. Asgard has been in charge for too long, and the realms have suffered for it. I wish to carry out my vision of harmony in the realms. I don't need you for this plan, however. I have been considering giving the crown to Loki, but you are clearly a stronger choice.
Thor summons all of his strength and breaks out of Malekith's spell. They both react fast, Malekith slightly faster. He unsheathes his jet-black sword, and it clashes against Thor's steel one.
I don't accept!
Thor swings another attack at Malekith, but it's parried. Malekith takes a step back from the fight and uses his magic once again to bind Thor to the nearest wall, causing him to drop his sword as he sails through the air.
While I have your attention, perhaps I can convince you that you are on the wrong side.
Malekith does more of his magic. This time, instead of attacking, he creates a memory in front of Thor. King Bor can now be seen talking to Malekith in the throne room, all alone.
Why have you taken my family?
That was simply to show you what I am capable of. And to have leverage.
For what purpose?
Bor rises from his throne.
I want you to invade Asgard.
Are you mad? Your people would slaughter mine!
You have material that I desperately need. My control over the realms wanes, and I require a powerful weapon.
Yet instead of making a deal with me, you take my family and demand I attack you.
You would never willingly part with the metal, would you?
It is vital to us, yes, but perhaps we could have spared some.
But not enough to satisfy my needs. I'm giving you this choice, Malekith. You invade my land and give my people a reason to invade yours. I will allow your people to escape to a safe new world with your family, and I will no longer bother you. What say you to this?
Malekith stands in silence for a moment, thinking.
Agreed.
Malekith exits the room without saying another word, and Bor smiles, glad his plan is working out.
As you can guess, he didn't keep his words. He stormed my world without a warning.
Asgardian troops flood Svartalfheim with Bor at the helm. Malekith's rage is seen on his face as he stands near the puck.
We had a deal, you petulant fool!
I have no idea to what you're referring. Asgardians, avenge your fallen comrades!
They came at us from all sides and destroyed many of my race. We were lucky enough to escape with the aid of my magic. I learned later, however, that Bor took his rage out on my family. He murdered them in cold blood. My son, who is only a babe. It was at that day that he lost the ability to wield his sacred hammer. That day that even a violent weapon would not heed to a bloodthirsty, power-craving man. Do you now see whose side you fight on?
I'm not my grandfather, nor is my father. I'm sorry for what has happened to you, but you must move on for the sake of your people. You cannot win this day.
Well then, Odinson, I'm afraid you leave me with no choice. You will meet your end at the hand of your grandfather's greed.
You may kill me, but my father will never kneel down to you. Asgard will not be yours.
You needn't worry about him. I already have him handled.
Back outside in the brawl, Kurse starts moving closer and closer to Odin, dispatching any Asgardian in his way. He soon makes it to Odin after thoroughly bloodying his axe.
This is your last battle, old father.
It is more likely to be yours.
Odin stabs his staff at Kurse, but it glances off of his axe. Odin is momentarily exposed, and Kurse takes advantage of it. He swings his axe at Odin's torso, but he rolls to the right. His golden cape is cut by the Dark Elf's weapon, but Odin is unharmed. Kurse goes in for another attack, raising his axe over his head and slamming it down. Odin's spear catches the hit, and he struggles to keep the axe from stabbing into his chest. Lady Sif moves forward to assist her king.
Don't! I can handle this.
Sif nods and takes a step back from Odin's fight. Odin knocks the end of his staff into Kurse's knee, which causes it to buckle. Kurse puts more strength into his axe, bringing it closer to Odin. In a matter of seconds, Odin slides out from under the sharp head of the axe and it bends itself to the bridge. Kurse tries to pull it out and fire off another strike at Odin, but he's too slow. Just as he almost had the axe out, the top part of the staff plunges into Kurse's heart. Kurse slumps over, and Odin removes the staff from his body. Loki walks up behind the Allfather and places his hand on his shoulder.
You don't look so well, Father. Perhaps you need some rest.
No, my boy. I'm perfectly fine.
Oh, I insist.
Loki summons powerful magic that causes Odin's one uncovered eye to close, and a wave of sleepiness floods over him. King Odin is now in the Odin sleep.
Rest well, deceiver.
Lady Sif surges at Loki, with anger flowing through her.
You traitor!
Loki winks at her before quickly opening a portal, stepping through it, and closing it in one fluid motion. Lady Sif's sword slices thin air. Lady Sif kneels down next to Odin.
Don't worry, my king. I shall protect you.
Lady Sif stands back up and readies her sword to stab into any approaching enemy, and it looks like she has her first customer. Two Dark Elves decide to take her on, raising their weapons and sprinting at her. Lady Sif smiles. Back in the palace, Thor is still bound to the wall and is trying his hardest to break free and stop Malekith, but he has yet to succeed. Malekith still fiddles with the destroyer's controls.
Don't fret. Your time is just about come.
The destroyer's eyes ignite with hellfire, and its metallic body begins to teet. It takes its first large step, followed by more, and trudges closer to Thor. He closes his eyes and thinks hard, hoping for a miracle.
I understand who I'm supposed to be. I'm my people's protector. I'm the realm's defender. Mjolnir, come to me so I can fulfill my destiny.
Thor expects to feel the hammer rush to his aid. It doesn't.
Even in your dying moments, you were not worthy. Goodbye, Odinson.
The destroyer opens up its face and sends a hot blast of energy directly at Thor, but it's blocked by something. Mjolnir flies out in front of Thor and takes the blow, not damaging it a bit. It then flies to Thor's hands and lightning begins to surround him. His bonds break, and he looks up at Malekith, eyes glowing blue.
I'm sick of your shite, Malekith. Your lust for revenge has caused the downfall of your people. Your reign is over.
Thor blasts the destroyer with lightning, increasing and increasing the charge with more power. The hard metal body begins to crack and rip. Its legs lose the ability to hold up the rest of the destroyer, and it cascades down to the ground. Malekith tries to attack the God of Thunder with his magic, but it's no use. Thor is too strong. Malekith is knocked down with a lightning strike, and Thor stands over him, Mjolnir pointed at his head.
Go ahead. Take your place among your murderous ancestors. Kill what's left of me.
No. You will rot in Asgard's dungeon for the rest of your existence. I hear it's nice down there, right next to the Enchantress.
Thor is about to help Malekith back up on his feet, but a dagger suddenly appears in his chest, and blood oozes from it.
What magic is this?
Malekith breathes his last breath, and his inky eyes roll to the back of his head. Thor reels around to find Loki, standing there with his signature smile.
Hello, brother.
Loki, what have you done?
Do you honestly think he deserved mercy?
I did. There was enough death plaguing this day already.
I am disappointed to see that he failed, though. However, not incredibly surprised.
What do you mean?
Isn't it obvious? I want the throne. With Odin out of the way, all that's left is you.
You must be jesting. Wait, where is Father?
In the Odin sleep. I locked him up within himself. You're in charge. For now.
Thor is more alert now, pointing Mjolnir at Loki, and is ready for any tricks he may have up his sleeve.
Loki, explain yourself!
It's simple, really. I'm not a son of Odin. He lied and stole me away from my true parents, but not without killing them first.
And where did you get these lies?
The dead elf polluting the floor there. He witnessed the event and gave me undeniable proof.
And yet you killed him!
He would have gotten in the way. It was for the best. Well, I'm afraid I better be going now. I heard rumor of a Midgardian searching for the Tesseract. Maybe I'll help him. Or perhaps just kill him and take it. You will see me again, Thor. And I will take Asgard.
Don't do this, Loki. Don't make me. Don't make me kill you.
Oh, please. You're not fast enough. Goodbye, brother.
Loki opens up a portal to Midgard and starts to walk through it. Thor quickly throws Mjolnir at him, but it's too late. Loki is gone.
No!
Mjolnir returns to his master, and Thor accepts that Loki has won. For now. Thor walks out of the armory and flies to the palace to the front gate. The battle still rages on without any of Malekith's supporters knowing that he has expired.
Enough fighting!
No one listens to his command, so Thor creates lightning and strikes it down on the bridge with a big roar. That gets all the warriors' attention.
Do you really think you can defeat me? Surrender now, and I promise you will be spared. I do not wish for our people to fight any longer. It's time for a change. Your leader's violence and your blind devotion has made me realize this.
One by one, the Dark Elves decide they cannot win their fight and lay down their arms. Thor smiles slightly, walking forward to his friends.
I see you've finally proven yourself.
I have. It makes situations like this easier.
Thor, Odin...
I know. Loki told me. When his energy has returned, he will take the throne again. But for now, it is up to me.
Where is the villain now?
Somewhere in Midgard. I need to find him before he gets himself in any more trouble. Heimdall, can you see him?
I close my eyes and try searching all of Midgard, but nothing. I cannot find him. I fear his magic is more powerful than any of us realized.
Then I must go find him myself. Send word to Niflheim that the battle is over. Lady Sif, Volstagg, look after my mother and father. I shall return when I've found Loki.
Give him hell for the old father, Thor.
We shall protect Asgard until you return.
Thor gives them one last nod, and the two of us head to the Bifrost's opening.
This is goodbye for now, my friend.
I will always watch over you, son of Odin. I wish you the luck of the gods on your quest. My only regret is that I cannot be of more help.
You've been more than helpful, Heimdall. I thank you. Now, to Midgard.
I open up the portal to the realms of the mortals, and Thor Odinson steps in, Mjolnir in hand, prepared to do anything to find and stop his brother before it's too late. The year is 2020 on Midgard, partly cloudy with a slight chance of storms late in the day. Our secret outpost in California just got word of a strange surge of energy in Baden-Württemberg, Germany, and now all eyes on the world map, waiting to see if something similar happens again. Above the map is an eagle emblem, the symbol for the Strategic Homeland Intervention Enforcement and Logistics Division, or put simply, SHIELD. A man in the back of the room keeps one eye firm on the map, his other being covered by an eye patch. Just then, another light goes off, another surge of energy, but not in Germany. This time, it is in Arizona.
What does this mean, Director?
Hell if I know, but it can't be good. I suggest you drive out to Arizona and see if you can find anything.
Will she maybe join me there too? I could use some backup.
Of course not, Coulson. She's still undercover. I know you have your eyes on her, but she's definitely not your type. Trust me.
Understood, sir. Oh, and I didn't mean it like that. It's just we've never gotten to talk, and she seems like someone fun to meet.
Just get going, Coulson. You're burning daylight.
Coulson nods and walks out of the room. He keeps a quick pace to the garage, where he selects one out of the nearly 100 jet block vehicles and drives off. He clicks a button on the dashboard, and a screen flips up showing him where the energy beam originated. He then presses hard on the gas, and the car zooms off towards Arizona. Before he knows it, he's near his destination. The car stops, and Coulson steps out of the car, putting his sunglasses on. He's arrived at a very hot and mostly barren desert. The only thing in sight is a blonde-haired man in weird attire. Coulson pulls out his phone and calls Director Fury.
Sir, I have eyes on a possible source. It's an oddly dressed man with long blonde hair.
Attempt to make contact, but do it carefully. We have no idea what he's capable of.
Will do, sir.
Coulson loosens his pistol within his holster, pockets his phone, and moves closer to the man. He raises his hand to wave at him, and the man begins to step forward. Coulson notices his huge hammer clutched in his hand and starts to worry a little bit, but he keeps his composure.
Ah, a Midgardian. Greetings.
Hi, Midgardian? You're talking to me, right?
Of course, Midgardian. Tis I, Thor Odinson.
Phil Coulson, so why am I a Midgardian?
This is Midgard after all, mortal. Since you live here, that makes you a Midgardian.
Around here we just call it Earth.
Earth? You crazy Midgardians. What a foolish name.
I thought it was pretty nice.
Tell me this, Midgardian Phil. Are you aware of where the Tesseract is? My brother Loki is after it, and I must stop him before he does something foolhardy.
Excuse me for a moment.
Coulson pulls out his phone, and Thor gives him an odd expression, wondering what he's holding in his hand.
Director, you're going to want to speak to this guy.